Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at percentages in numbers. So I get a lot of questions about doing percentages in numbers. Now, percentages aren't anything special that you do in spreadsheets. Percentages are basically just simple division. You take a smaller number, divide it into a larger number, and you get a fractional result. For instance, if you had 5 people out of a group of 20, you would divide by 5 by 20 and get 0.25, which is 25%. So it's pretty simple math. But there are some special things in spreadsheets that can help you at least display percentages. So let's look at a simple spreadsheet and take that example and say we have 5 as the group and 20 is the total. So we wanted to calculate the percentage of 5 out of 20. So we would do that simply by using a formula, starting with the equals sign here and then clicking on this cell divided by this cell. And we see the answer there, 0.25, which is the fraction that represents 5 over 20. And it's also the percent, except percent are usually represented with the decimal point moved over 2 places. So instead of 0.25, you would simply say 25%. And we could do that by multiplying the number by 100, but it's actually easier with a spreadsheet to leave it in its true format as a fraction and then use a formatter like this percentage up here to show it as a percent. And that will actually move the decimal point over 2 places and put the percent symbol after the number. And we can further customize this by bringing up the inspector. So let's go and bring up the inspector here and we'll look at formats here. And then under cell format it's already set to percentage. That's a percentage there. And we can change the number of decimal places. We may want to just see without any decimals at all like that. So there's a few other things you can do, but that's the main thing and you get 25% there. Now if this group were to change, the formula would update automatically. 7 out of 20 would be 35% and 14 would be 70%. Now this is a simple example. I'm just dividing 2 numbers. So let's remove these and create something a little bit more complex. I'm going to go ahead and add a footer row here where I can do the total. Let me shrink this table a bit to make it a little easier. And say I'm going to enter in a bunch of different numbers. Great. And what I want to do here is create the total at the bottom. There. So now I've got something you might typically do in a spreadsheet. You've added up a bunch of numbers. There's the total. If I add more, it will increase the total here. I can automatically update it like that. And say now I wanted to get what percentage each of these groups was. So I could do equals and do that cell right there divided by this cell and I get that fraction there and I could change the cell format there to percentage. And let's have 0 decimals and I could see that's 15%. Now what if I wanted to do that for each one of these? Of course that would be the idea. So I can copy this formula and paste it in here. And what I'm going to get is it's not going to work because if I look at that formula it's moved these 2 cells down. Instead of this one here being B2 divided by B7, now it's B3 divided by B8. There is no B8 because it goes all the way down to 7 and stops. So I want to modify the formula. I always want it to be the total here. I could do that one of many ways. One is I could change this here instead of being B7, I could do sum of B. And now that will work. And this is kind of independent of this column here at the bottom. So you don't even, this row here at the bottom, you don't even need this row anymore. It's kind of independent of this. So now if I copied this and pasted it, I would get the percentage of each one right there. Another way to do this would be to change this formula. So I do actually use the total at the bottom like that, but I change it to be an absolute. So I can do the absolute row is the important thing. So that with the dollar sign there after 7 means that 7 isn't going to change. So if I were to copy this and paste it here, you can see it's B3 divided by B7, B4 divided by B7, B5 divided by B7, etc. And I get the same result. Either way, I get a percentage here of what each one is. 6 represents 15% of 41, 4 represents 10% of 41, 16 represents 39% of 41, etc. So it's another useful way to use percentages in a spreadsheet. Here's another example that I've set up. I have here a table that shows a list of items and I want to see how often items appear. I have apples, oranges, and bananas in this list. I want to see what percent of the time apples appear. Now this is a short list, but imagine if this was hundreds of thousands of items long. So I have a second table here where I've set up the first column to be the equivalent apple, orange, banana, exactly as these are. And I want to see how many times does apple appear here and then figure out the percentage. So I'm going to do a formula, and the formula I'm going to use a function called countif. So always look through the formula browser here and you can see all sorts of cool functions that you can use for different situations. And it's good to just browse that, especially if you use spreadsheets a lot. So I'm going to countif and I'm going to put the range in here. So it's going to go to table 1 and it's going to say from A1 to A17. And then I'm going to give it the value. And I could put quote apple, but instead, since I have the word apple over here already, I'm just going to click there and then I'll put A1 in, the equivalent to putting quote apple. But it'll be more useful later on. And I see that 8 appear. 8 times apple appears in this list. Now if I wanted to further copy and paste this into orange and banana, first thing I want to do is I want to make sure that the column and row here for the beginning and end of this, it's all absolute. So I'm going to change it like that. So it's absolute row, absolute column. So as I copy and paste it, this remains steady even though the second one, A1, changes to A2 and A3. Another way I could do this is I could simply use the entire set there. So I can say table 1A and that will work as well. So let's do that one. I'm going to copy this and paste it here and I can see now it's still table 1, column A, and A2 instead of A1, which is orange. And I'm going to paste it here and there I've got banana. And there's 3 of them. So now what I want is percentage. I want to know what percent of these are apples. So it's going to be 8 divided by the total number here. So looking through the functions database, I can see that there's a way to tell how many items are in this column. And that's to use the COUNTA function. If you look through it, you would think COUNT, but then you would read the definition of it and say, no, it's COUNTA that I want. And COUNTA would, I just put in table 1A in there by clicking on the column heading. And now it's going to be basically the number of times apple appears in that column divided by the total number of items in that column. And you can see I get 0.47. I know that's going to be 47%. Let me then convert that to a percentage here. Go to the formatting here and I don't want to get rid of the decimal places. There we go, 47%. Great. So now I can copy that and paste it here and orange is 35%. And banana is 18%. So there are 3 ways to use percentages in spreadsheets. Now if you're looking to use percentages, chances are your situation is different. There's a nearly infinite number of ways you can use percentages in spreadsheets. So hopefully this gives you the basics and the understanding of what percentages are and how to use them in spreadsheets so you can apply them to your needs. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it'll just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.